In this example, we'll analyze some kinetic data that corresponds to drug concentration as a function of time. So at time equals zero, 300 milligrams of drug was injected as just one dose. And then at 1, 2, 6, and 12 hours, the concentration was measured of the drug in the bloodstream. Here's what we want to calculate from these data. What's the rate constant for decay of the drug concentration? What's the initial concentration? In other words, right after we inject it, we only made a measurement after 1 hour. Can we back calculate what was the concentration at time equals zero? From the fact that we know the amount injected and we're going to calculate the concentration at time equals zero, can we calculate the volume of the blood? If we know the rate constant, then can we calculate the half-life of the drug? In other words, the time for it to reach half of its original concentration. Term called the cumulative area under the curve, AUC, is a common one that's used that we want to also be able to calculate that. So essentially we have something that we're modeling as a reactor, has a volume. We inject a certain amount of drug, in this case 300 milligrams. The concentration of drug decreases with time. We want to analyze that data. One approach would be to guess what the behavior is. So for example, we could guess that it's first order. If so, the log of the concentration of the drug versus time, t, should be linear. So this is the integral method that we're looking at the data here. So what I've done is plot on a spreadsheet the concentration versus time, where now I've taken the logs, and here are the values you can see that entered into the spreadsheet, namely time, concentration, and then the log values, and the log is what's plotted here. Looks pretty close to a straight line, but we can use Excel to get a good idea of how well it fits a straight line, and indeed it fits quite well. And what I'm plotting here is then the slope and the intercept. So this equation, if you look on a spreadsheet, what this is index, and then this is the equation for linear regression. So cells F5 to F8, so that's the y-axis, that's the log of the concentration. And then the x-axis, it's D5 to D8. And if I put a comma and put a 1 here, then it's going to give me the slope. And then if I put a 2 here instead, this will give me the intercept. So by using this, then it gives me intercept. Using 1, I get the slope. Look at the other numbers, the fit is quite good. So the slope then, if it's first order, the concentration of drug, or the log of the concentration, is the log of the initial concentration minus kt. So this is a slope. So this means k equals 0.144 if the slope is minus 0.144. And this is hours to the minus 1. This is the intercept, so this is 2.92. If the log of the initial drug concentration is 2.92, then this initial drug concentration is 18.6 milligrams per liter. This initial concentration would be equal to how much we injected divided by the volume. So 18.6 milligrams per liter. That's the concentration initially we calculate. We injected 300 milligrams, so this means we can solve for the volume 16.1 liters, or probably realistically 16 liters. Problem asks us to calculate the half-life, and the half-life is just the log of 2 over k. You can see that just results from the concentration at any given time is initial concentration e to the minus kt. So if we want the concentration to be half of our initial concentration, that would correspond to the half-life time. If we just rearrange this, this cancels. It doesn't matter when we start this. We can take the log of 0.5 is equal to minus kt 1/2, or we can rearrange this. And so we can show that the half-life is just log of 2 over k. So for For our problem, then the half-life is log of 2 divided by our rate constant, 0.144 hours to minus 1. So our half-life is 4.8 hours. Well, the last part of this problem is, what's the area under the curve? And so the concentration of drug is its initial concentration, e to the minus 0.144 times t. So if we wanted to integrate over this time scale, 0 to 12 hours, of the concentration, so this is the concentration of drug times dt, so an integral from 0 to 12 of 18.6 e to the time dependence, and of course integral of this exponent is just an exponent, so the integral constant exponent divided by this k value here, and so we can substitute in the limits. This ratio is 129.16, and we now have e to the minus 0.1444 times 12 minus e to the 0, and if we do the calculation, this comes out to 106. So the area under the curve, 106, this is milligrams, hours per liter.